We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at U.S. Marshal Bass Reeves Issue 1. This is from Alliance Arts and Entertainment from 2020, written by Kevin Grevioux. David Williams was the artist, Kelsey Shannon colorist. David Williams with Kelsey Shannon did the cover, which the cover is actually pretty cool. Looks pretty hardcore. Eric Weathers was the letterer. Hernan Octavio was the color flatter. I don't know what that is. Patrick Stiles was the editor. So this book is about the legendary Marshal Bass Reeves, who was an amazing character in history. The guy was as hardcore as they come. Fast on with a gun, great with disguises, and even arrested his own son. As an old man, no less. He had a stellar career as a U.S. Marshal and is a fascinating character. If you get a chance to look him up, he's also said to be the inspiration for the Lone Ranger. So this is an origin issue where Bass Reeves is just now deciding to become a lawman and his journey to that. And it's a really interesting story. We get to see how he interacts with his family, how he comes to work for Judge Parker, and how well known he is in the territories where he is the marshal. It's a very well told story. The ideology of the time is handled very maturely and very well. This was a very interesting comic book in many, many regards. It shows his ability to language as well as his disguise and his legend at the time. So I definitely enjoyed this was a really fun book. The art style isn't one I generally care for, but it is well done for that style. The colors really bring out the book. I never knew Kelsey Shannon to do coloring, but he's actually pretty good at it, and the art is good for its style. I thought it was okay. It didn't bother me, even though it's not a style I generally like. It did work for the story, and I really am fascinated by the character to begin with because I have a little bit of knowledge about who he is, and I think a lot of people don't, and this will be a great introduction to Bass Reeves as a legend and as a historical figure. So I have to say, this is a really good story all the way around. It's great visual storytelling, and it's a solid comic. It's a little overpriced at $5, though. The cover quality is kind of crap, because it's the same paper as the interior. The interior paper's fine for interior paper. It's pretty good. It does have a little bit of fluting, but not bad. But the cover quality needs to be a little bit different, I think. You can only get these in Walmart or through secondary sources, but if you want to get them new, you got to go to Walmart and get them. If you're against Allegiance Arts or the Brightwisers for the way they handled their Red Rooster campaign or lack of delivery, then you'll probably not want to purchase this, but I won't hold it against these creators. This book was really, really solid, and I'm going to recommend it. I thought it was a solid piece of work, good comic storytelling. If you don't want to support the Brightwisers because of the way Red Rooster was handled, buy this through the secondary market and get it so they don't get their money and you still get the book, because this is a really, really fun book, and I am absolutely going to check out issue 2. But that's just my opinion. Thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button and subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you want to help the channel in other ways, links to my Patreon, Subscribestar, and Streamlabs are in the description below. And as always, we hope to see you on the next one.